You're listening to Kearney Live on 102.7 KPGZ. Kearney Live is presented by Kearney Trust Company. Kearney Trust, 310 West 92 Highway in Kearney. The phone number is 816-628-6666. And now here's the hosts of Kearney Live, Mike Davis and Jim Dickerson.
Thank you. Thank you. That's the live studio audience. Yeah, they're here every week. It's the same slobs that keep showing up. We need to get a new crowd in here, I got to tell you. Every single week, these people make a mess. Brian's got to clean up after them. I mean, spilled Cokes, popcorn all over the floor, just like a movie theater. And Jim, what are we going to do with these people?
I don't know, but I'm just glad they keep showing up.
Me too.
So we got that going for us.
You are listening to or watching Kearney Live here on Wednesday. We love it. It's our favorite show on Wednesday at noon. It's the only show on Wednesday at noon. Producer-engineer Brian Watts is with us today, and he is pushing buttons and moving levers. And actually, yep, thank you, Brian. Yep, that's the audience. Yep, it's a bit of a golf clap right there, sounded to me like, but they were being polite. Because they know Brian is the hardest working man in Kearney. Today, we have a very special guest with us that we'll get on here in a minute. We have Shawntel Reickard, and she is about to be the executive program administrator, of Fulfillment House. And for those of you who live in Kearney, you certainly know about the Fulfillment House and the terrific work they do here, but we'll talk a little bit more in depth about that. And Jim Dickerson, my good friend and co-host, has a couple of announcements to make. And Jim, tell us what you got on your mind.
Well, thank you, Mike. Hey, there's a couple things we wanted to talk about. First of all, I wanted to throw a shout out and congratulations to all the guys on the Bulldog football team. There are a large number of them that were chosen for not only their play, but also their academics. And we were going to read the list, but the list is so extensive because there's so many of them that, quite frankly, when we've talked about the football program and everything over there, the play is one thing, but the academics is another. And so such a solid performance for all those guys. So congratulations to them. If you want to go look them up name by name, person by person, you can go to our Facebook page. We have a bunch of them. Twitter feed also has them. You can go to the Kearney Bulldogs page. They have them listed as well. So congratulations to those guys.
And absolutely, one. Jim, if I could, when you talk about student athletes, and sometimes that term gets bandied about, I think particularly at the collegiate level, and is maybe not quite as meaningful as it certainly appears to be here, and in fact it is meaningful at the high school level, and certainly at Kearney, Missouri with the Bulldogs. As we watched these kids play, and as we've had them in the studio, many of these guys we've visited with, talked to before and after the game, terrific individuals. And as I saw the names on that list, and I encourage you to go have a look at our Facebook page and find out who those kids are, I'm not the least bit surprised. Just really, really cool. And congratulations on being great students, great citizens, as well as fun football players to watch.
Yeah, and we also have a number of awards to give out. We were supposed to go to the awards dinner, which was supposed to be Sunday, but if you remember, the weather got bad, so that's been put off. But a number of awards for the Stables Kearney Players of the Week, and we're going to give those awards out when that gets rescheduled, so we're looking forward to that. Also wanted to throw a shout-out and a congratulations to the Kearney Chamber of Commerce as it relates to their Shop Local campaign. Now, we've been doing quite a bit with that as well. If you've been following us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, you name it, it's been everywhere. But that program, the Shop Local campaign, has been tremendously successful this year. Just wanted to say congratulations to the Chamber for that. We're planning to work with them and continue that into 2020. And let that program continue to grow. So if you can, especially as we go into the holiday season here and the Christmas season, remember to shop local whenever possible. I know Mike and Brian and I have. And Also this morning, they gave away some money.
$1,500 worth.
Yes. And so the winner of that was on, I believe we had it on Facebook Live this morning.
Right.
Because Brian made us get up and go to this breakfast at 7:30 in the morning, and Mike and I are ready for a nap. So if you see us doze off here,
you'll know why.
Minutes, you'll know what happened.
Right.
But anyway, the winner was...
You're going to make me remember now.
I remember who it was.
Go for it.
It was Christy Mayo.
Right.
She won $1,500. So... There you go.
Right.
So, Christy, right. I spoke with you earlier, but if you need me to resend you my Christmas list, I've got it out alphabetical starting with Catherine. For those of you who get the movie reference, anybody? Anybody?
No. No, it's, yeah, the crickets. That's the crickets.
That's Christmas Vacation. How could you not? Clark, that's a real
Well, there's
surprise.
A lot of people that listen to this show who have not seen that movie. In fact, we're not even born. So, yeah.
Are there people that really have not seen
Jim.
Christmas
Yeah,
Vacation?
People who haven't seen Star Wars.
Oh, my gosh. Right?
Yeah.
So, I'm devastated.
I know. Don't tell anybody.
I'm devastated. Yeah, but anyway, congratulations, Christy. That was awesome this morning.
Yes,
$1,500 to her. So, and congratulations to the Chamber.
Right. Yeah. Shop Local campaign will be ongoing. We are in partnership with them in seeing to it that we keep the momentum flowing and, I think folks are getting a better sense of how Shop Local works. We shot two new videos. We're not going to show one today because we'd like to put a fresh one up. We shot two of them today, and we will get those put together. And we'll see how it goes throughout the year. But it's a lot of work to put them together, but it's a lot of fun when it's all done. So keep your eyes open for those on Facebook, and we'll have some fun with them.
One more announcement, I'm told, and then we're done.
All right.
So for those of you who cling to every moment of this show, and I know there's
at least two. How do we know that? Your wife and mine. Yeah.
Well, mine's out of town, so.
Yeah, okay, one. Our listener. But anyway, for our listener's benefit.
I have big news for you. Next week. There will be no show because it's Christmas, so it'll be a rerun, I think. Is that right? Nope. It's just going to be like Christmas music or something, so you won't have to listen to us again. And then the following week is New Year's Day, and there's no show then either. So
we'll be a no-show.
It will not be a show. So we'll be back on January 8th, which is like 3 weeks from... It was my understanding there would be no math. But anyway, we'll be back on January 8th, and so we look forward to seeing you then. So actually, this is our last show of 2019.
That's exciting.
And the last show of the decade, if you want to look at it that way.
I thought you were going to cue the audience applause for finally
last,
those
finally
guys shut
last
up.
Show of the decade. So, Mike, when you and I get together on this show again, it'll be a new decade.
2020. I know you just can't even imagine that it's, 2020. I mean, I never thought I'd make it this long.
Do you remember what you were doing at the last decade?
I
2009, think, what were you doing?
Right. Just slogging through life as I am right now, just kind of stumbling along and hoping that I get a paycheck. You know, it doesn't always happen.
Excellent. Well, that was uplifting.
That's true.
For more uplifting stories, let's go to Mike Davis.
You know what? I am so excited to have Shawntel Reickard. Did I get the name right? The Reickard part? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And Shawntel, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I have to say this is likely. No, there's no doubt in my mind that this is the first time we've had somebody on this show who has not yet started for the company that we're featuring. So you've been hired, but you haven't started. Is that correct? With the fulfillment house?
Yeah, that's correct.
Now, how does a thing like that happen? Why and how did you get started working with the fulfillment house?
Well, I went in there and I applied to be a job coach. They were hiring for job coaches, which is where you go in and you help pack the boxes.
Right.
You show the associates how to pack the boxes and help them pack. And Jill interviewed me. She was the director at the time, or right. is the director currently. Mm-hmm. And she interviewed me. And as we went through the interview, she started to ask me some questions that weren't really pertaining to the job coach position. And they were a little bit more difficult questions.
You had to do math, you mean?
Yeah, and the questions got a little bit more difficult. Right. And finally she said, the reason that I'm asking these questions is because I think you're more qualified to do a different job. Would you be interested in interviewing to be the director of the fulfillment house? And I said, yes, absolutely.
You got a promotion without even working
there. Yeah, it was awesome. Right. And so we went ahead and set up an interview with the board, and I came back and interviewed with the board, and it was a fantastic interview. It was an hour and 10 minutes. I got in the car and I looked at the clock and it had been an hour and 10 minutes. I said, that was the best interview I've ever had in my life.
Nailed it.
It was amazing.
Right.
Yeah. And it was so good. I went home and I just waited by the phone and I was so nervous, and the call finally came and she offered me the job, and it was amazing. It was so cool.
What a great story.
Yeah.
I mean, you just love the sound of success. So that's wonderful.
It's awesome.
Yeah. And I think, as I mentioned, I believe that people in Kearney, Missouri certainly know about the Fulfillment House. And I heard you say the associates, who are the folks who work there.
Mm-hmm.
And you talked about filling boxes. Well, fulfillment is, in direct mail and advertising and marketing terms, or anything that needs, it's really anything that needs to be shipped or packaged. So tell me, just for the benefit of some of the folks who just as a review, what the Fulfillment House does and kind of, you know, where it started and how it started.
They have campaigns. So there are... right now, there are three campaigns. There are three different authors, if I'm correct, and I'm probably butchering it, but and it's just because I'm so new.
You're new. Yeah.
But there are three different campaigns, and they are books and DVDs, if I'm
right.
Correct. And they are putting the books and DVDs in boxes,
mm-hmm.
and then they put their little cards in there that have their, and it's really, really sweet. They have their face on there and their names.
Right. The associate has their own individual personalized card.
And it's really sweet. Yep. And it says who they are and what they're doing. And they put that in there. And they go ahead and they pack them up, and it's really cool. And they're set up every day. They had, like, on Mondays, they have sometimes between 800 and 1,000 orders. That's a lot of orders to
sure
fill.
Is.
It's really a really neat thing. And they go ahead and pack them up. They put labels on them. They put tape on them, and then they'll load them up and put them on the delivery trucks. It's really a cool thing that they do. And they do that from 10 o'clock in the morning until 2 o'clock in the afternoon. They'll have lunch together. And then when they are finished, if there's any downtime, they'll do something enriching together. They'll do yoga. They'll go play basketball together. They've done activities in the park together. They play dice, which is really cool. I think it's Farkle is what they play together.
Oh, I thought maybe there was a crap game going on.
Oh, right. Yeah. Wouldn't that be fun to teach them how to gamble? We probably shouldn't do that. Maybe not encourage that as much.
That brings up a question, Brian. Why don't we go play basketball or do yoga here?
I really think that maybe you should come. I think that would be awesome.
She can tell by looking at us. Yeah, we need to.
Absolutely.
We need more physical activity.
Yeah.
And Brian, I don't know why you're pointing at us.
Yes.
Well, I want to be very clear, too, that the Fulfillment House is, and I'm going to sort of read and paraphrase here, is a passion project for local mm-hmm. business owners, Steve Thorne and Lynn Page of Paradigm Direct. I got that? That's on the web. Website. And the aim there is to help guide family and friends who have children with special needs transitioning into their adult years to sustain a fulfilling lifestyle.
Absolutely.
What I love about that statement is you talk about a fulfilling lifestyle and the Fulfillment House
mm-hmm.
and how the meaning, the double meaning of fulfillment sort of satisfies that whole thing. I just love the sound of that. Many of these special needs children have gone through the Kearney, Missouri School District.
Uh-huh. Yes.
And as I understand it, once those kids get through high school, their options are oftentimes limited.
Yeah.
And so the fulfillment house helps to fulfill that need.
Yeah, absolutely. The job market out there in the real world is very limited for people with special needs. Mm-hmm. There's not a lot of support or structure for people with special needs. Once you get out there, for example, I currently work in a restaurant. I work at Texas Roadhouse and I do the marketing there. And it's very difficult to provide support for people with special needs because there's not separated quality time mm-hmm. to give to people with special needs. There's not a structured setup for people with special needs.
Right.
And that's just not a dedicated thing that is allowed in a corporate setting. There's not money for that. There's not time for that. There's not a structured setting for that. And so what the Fulfillment House does is it provides that opportunity for people with special needs to have a job coach, to have specialized right. coaching and time and allow them to be successful in an environment where they're not pressured, where they're not pushed and looked down on or told to hustle or told they're not going fast enough or told right. they're not doing a good enough job. They're allowed to be successful and excel and do a great job and inspired. And I love that we've provided that for them, that right. that's where we go and that they get to enjoy what they do and spend time together and make friends and enrich their lives. And not only are they enriching each other's lives, but then they get to enrich the lives of everybody around them, their job coaches, the people that are in the community, right. volunteers. I mean, it just, they're enriching our community by being here and doing that job. I mean, how much have they done for Kearney just by being here and being a part of our community? I love that. It's just so fulfilling for our community.
So you're leaving Texas Roadhouse?
I am.
That's a huge void. Now,
yeah, but it's done a lot for me.
I want to make sure Texas Roadhouse will remain open.
It will. It stands on its own. It's a very great place.
Tragedy averted, America.
Yes, it is. You know. Yes, it's a great restaurant. It's done a lot for me. I earned.
It's done a lot for me, too.
It's wonderful. And I earned my marketing experience there. I gained so much from that place. It's a wonderful restaurant. It really is.
So how do they make the people come out and dance on the?
Oh, here we go.
Well, I got no. two.
I mean, do they really have to make them? I mean, they turn the music on and you dance. It's fun. It's awesome.
I don't dance, but for obvious reasons.
So we're gonna send Texas Roadhouse a bill for this free ad that you're giving. Right.
I do have a question. Have they started to shy away from throwing the peanuts on the floor or the peanut shells on the floor?
It's part of the atmosphere. It's part of what Texas Roadhouse is all about.
Okay, just like my house.
Yeah, that's why. I mean, we put signs up because that's just part of the atmosphere.
Right. Please throw your peanut shells on the floor. Right.
It's just part of Texas Roadhouse's story.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it.
Even though, like, a lot of people have peanut allergies, it's part of Texas Roadhouse's story.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
If you're allergic to peanuts, you can go somewhere else.
Yeah, you probably shouldn't go there. Yeah, that's probably a bad thing. But anyway.
We are visiting today.
Unfortunately. I mean, there's other options for people who have peanut allergies.
Well, agreed and understood. And Shawntel Reickard is with us today. She is not quite with the Fulfillment House, but she has been hired by the Fulfillment House. She's the Executive Program Administrator. We're going to be right back and talk a little bit more with her about the Fulfillment House. Stay with us. You're listening to Kearney Live.
Say thank you to these local underwriters who support KPGZ.
Simplify your banking, simplify your life. It's easy with Kearney Trust Company. The world has become fast-paced, and we understand that you are busy. That's why we offer a banking experience that's as simple and stress-free as can be. Kearney Trust goes beyond convenient locations and good customer care to offer banking services that make managing your finances quicker and easier than ever before. Online, bill pay, e-statements, and mobile banking are available to give you a positive banking experience so you can get back to your life and activities. Kearney Trust also provides capital to people and businesses so they can achieve their goals. Whether you know exactly what you want or just need someone to talk to about your dream, you can speak with them and work on that dream. You may just be getting off the ground or ready to move into your brick and mortar building. Kearney Trust will provide you and your business with the resources you need to succeed. Kearney Trust Company is your partner for success with two convenient locations in Kearney at 310 West 92 Highway and 701 Watson Drive in Price Chopper. The phone is 816-628-6666. Kearney Trust Company, banking you can trust. Member FDIC.
Welcome back to Kearney Live on our last show of the decade, and a Merry Christmas to everyone out there.
I like that bumper music.
I do.
That
I
was
like
nice.
Can now, we do well, it more often?
Well done, Brian.
Yeah. It's nice. Hey, we were talking a little bit when we went to break about Texas Roadhouse, and I got chastised by Mike for giving free advertisement. So Mike said the way we can make that up is if you're at Texas Roadhouse and you want to bring us over to the station some lunch, we are available for that.
455 South Sandbar Drive, Suite 209.
And just knock on the door. We'll get to you.
We'll eat it.
Not a problem.
Yeah, yeah.
I would like my steak medium.
Mine as well.
Or whatever you, and the rolls. It was brought up to us that the rolls.
You
and I
throw,
love the
throw
rolls.
Your roll at Brian.
So,
yeah. Yeah.
That's enough of that. So back to the show at hand, and back to that we are, is Mike Davis.
Thank you, Jim. We are with Shawntel Reickard, and she's the Executive Program Administrator at the Fulfillment House. The Fulfillment House story is one that is just, I think, for particularly parents who have a child with special needs, understand how challenging it can be for their kids once they're out of high school, to find gainful employment and to maintain that job. I personally have seen and know a family, some good friends of mine that I went to high school with, by the way, whose son has done very well working at a local Hy-Vee and also at Home Depot. He's another guy with special needs that has just done terrifically. On his own, I think, by and large, with very few exceptions. I think the from me, from my personal point of view, these people are well capable, highly functioning members of our society who I think in past years were overlooked when it came to being given an opportunity to make a living for themselves, to feel a they are a valuable member of our society. Talk to me a little bit about how the Fulfillment House, and I know it's early for you because you really don't work there yet.
Yeah.
But I know you know enough about it, and you were getting ready to volunteer as a job coach. Talk to me about how the Fulfillment House has helped to give these folks a place to work and a sense of purpose in their life.
Well, it provides an opportunity for them to have jobs and have that gainful employment. And then it does provide that enriching opportunity after they're done with their task for the day. It provides that they sit together and they have lunch. They communicate with one another. They do something after they're finished with their task. So once they've packed all the boxes and they're done for the day, mm-hmm. if they have time left over in the day, which oftentimes they do, unless they're, you know, they're totally packed for the day. But oftentimes, if they've got 30 minutes left in the day, they'll do something together. They'll go and do yoga together, something enriching, something just wonderful, some task where they can learn to be friends, learn how to communicate. That, you know, that's something that we take for granted so often, is just how to interact with one another, right. Talking, social media has taken so much of that away from us, just how to interact with one another, how to talk face to face, how to be friends. How to be friends is so enriching. And that's so important. How to be a real friend, how to talk, how to have a conversation and tell a joke. And that's just so important to be able to do those things. They have a staff meeting in the morning and they come in and they talk about what they did the night before. They talk about what they're planning on doing this weekend. They talk about, you know, whatever they want. Jill was telling me that there are people that never, ever used to communicate in the staff meetings that talk a lot now.
Yeah.
And that is so cool that they've opened up, that they're communicating with one another. What a neat thing to see them grow, to watch little teeny tiny things that you wouldn't notice become huge growing opportunities. Every day you see great growth. I love that.
And I know the Fulfillment House has gotten, you guys have a pretty big person that has their book distributed through there, I think. Charles Payne?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that's no small feat.
Pretty big deal.
Pretty popular. A lot of people know who he is.
Yeah.
So how he got involved with that?
I know that Steve Thorne got him involved with that, and he does a lot of that marketing through Paradigm. So, you know, he's in charge of all of that. As far as the marketing and what books come through Fulfillment House, Steve and Paradigm and Cece are all in charge of that. So I'm not exactly sure.
Right.
Pretty impressive that somebody of that stature has, runs their book through the Fulfillment House. So it's not just like, you know, people are pushing crayons or something through there. I mean, it's a real, real big deal.
Yeah.
And the volume you guys do is outstanding.
Yes.
On a daily basis.
And we hope to be able to grow that. I mean, right now we have 9 associates and we hope to be able to get to the point where we have more. I mean, we employ 9 now because that's all that we can afford. Eventually we'd like to increase that so that we can afford to pay more people. If we are employing 9 now, we'd like to employ, 10 or 11 or 12 because we'd like to get to the point where we can afford to do that. But we have to, make more money in order to do that. It's a non-for-profit. So we have to make more money in order to pay more associates. And that just comes with fundraising and time. And that's my goal, is to make more money, to be able to get out there and do some fundraising and make more money.
Right. That, with your marketing background, I would imagine you will be able to do something like that.
That's my goal. Yeah, absolutely.
And if you want to make more money, who better to go to than Charles Payne?
Right.
No doubt about that.
Absolutely. You better read that book.
Yep.
In fact, if you'd like to see this online, Brian, I think, Brian, you've got you may have the website up. I'm not sure. But if you click through the partners link, you can see Charles Payne has his picture there. And John and Pete Najarian. Did I get that right?
I believe so.
Yeah. And Stephanie Cameraman are 3 of the partners who have books that are being packaged.
There's Charles on the left of your screen.
At the Fulfillment House. So the fact is, the Fulfillment House is a going concern. I mean, this is a real legitimate business that, in fact, if I wanted to do some fulfillment, even for the radio station, I could call them up and say, what would it cost to send out, I don't know, coffee mugs or something like that. And I could get a bid and a quote for what it would take to do however many I wanted to be delivered wherever I want it, correct?
Absolutely. And I mean, ideally it would have to be something that we could fulfill. It would depend on size and whether or not we could move it. But I mean,
size, you mean like the quantity, the numbers or?
Yeah, and whether or not we have size for it, or like room for it in the warehouse things like
storage,
that. We are growing and you know, we'll see. Eventually we'd like to expand and become bigger and we'll see where it goes.
Right. Yeah. And you guys are located. I know I've been in there before. What's the address up there? Does anybody know that? I don't know. I think it should be
on here.
It probably is. I don't know that it's all that necessary right now.
It's 115 West Washington Street.
Listen to you prepared.
There we go.
Nice job. So question that probably comes up is, you guys obviously accept donations of whatnot?
Of course.
So what are you guys looking at? Obviously money, but what are you looking for? How do people do it? What's the best way to contribute?
I would say that we would need to go on the website, thefulfillmenthouse.org, and I believe that there's a donation link on there. That would probably be the best way.
Yes, there is.
Or you could call call the fulfillment house. The phone number is 816-635-7049. And you could talk to myself or Jill. Mm-hmm. Jill right now and myself again, after so the prepared. Second.
Yeah. You act like you work there.
Right?
You don't absolutely. Even work there.
Mike could probably take a lesson or two from you on how to be prepared. Just saying.
This is I'm the one who actually does the show.
Prep, well,
so,
yeah.
So
he's got a point.
Yeah. So I do want to, I did want to find out all of your associates are Kearney residents or are there others? Are they from other areas?
I believe most of them are Kearney or Liberty.
Okay, cool. Yeah. And you said you've got 9 right now.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, the pictures on this website are wonderful. And there are pictures on the, I believe it's on the homepage. And at some point, Brian might pop that up there for us. But you can see the associates there. And I see the job coaches. Now, do you have an individual job coach for each associate? Or is there not one for one?
Yeah, no. Okay. Right now we have, I believe, 2 job coaches. I'm working on 3.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And are those volunteer positions or?
No, they're paid.
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah. Cool.
We do have volunteers. Mm-hmm. We have volunteer, associate volunteers, and we have volunteers that come in from the community as well.
Very cool. And again, you know, go to the website or make the phone call if you want to volunteer.
Of course, always accepting volunteers.
Right. And I have, as I say, I have been in there. I was in there, I think, right after lunch, and I believe they were ready to close the doors the one day that I was in there.
Were they?
And I was completely engaged by every one of those associates sitting awesome. There at the table. And I had such a fun time visiting with all of them. And of course, Brent is, you know, one of our good friend of the radio station. He's he's been on the air with us before.
Awesome.
And terrific guy. And I cannot tell you if you have an opportunity someday, go have lunch with them, bring them lunch and sit in and talk with those folks. And they will have you in stitches before you leave. I promise. But great time. Yeah.
Yeah.
Didn't Brent, he did the weather for us one day or something like that?
I think he did a weather promo.
A weather promo or something?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And I've heard him do the little tagline.
I think he
a
did.
A few times. Didn't yeah. he do a couple
yeah.
of those?
Yeah.
And I think we're going to have another one of those
yes, we are.
Later today.
Yeah. In fact, we've got Ashley Giglio. Did I get that right? Yeah. Yes, I did. She's going to be on the air here in just
here
a minute.
Shortly.
Yeah, just real shortly. But Shawntel Reickard is with us today. She's the executive program administrator to be. You are the you haven't been confirmed yet. So
right.
Yeah, but as soon as you, I guess when is your first day?
January 2nd officially.
All right, so you can party and enjoy your time off. Or are you still at that steak place that I'm not going to mention?
Yes, just finishing up.
There. I got
not
you.
Anymore.
Wrapping up loose ends.
Did you tell them you're leaving?
I did.
Okay,
because
yeah.
I was going to say, wouldn't?
Yeah,
this,
right. That would be awful.
Yeah, could you imagine? Oops.
Yeah,
they'd be like,
yeah,
isn't she our marketing
right
person?
On the radio?
Yeah.
That would
yeah.
be a little embarrassing.
Did you get him on the phone? Can you get him on the phone? Tell him that we did need some lunch, by the way.
Just so you know, I have not heard a knock at the door.
Nope. Texas Roadhouse in Liberty. Where are you with right. our steaks?
I'm starving over here.
And rolls. And
right.
baked potato.
Because somebody in the room, and I'm not going to name any names, brought up the rolls. Now I can't stop thinking about it.
Bless
you.
Yeah,
that's okay. We'll meet her here in a few minutes, and then we can discuss the roll problem.
When I see these, this is one of those, it's a business in Kearney that is unique, and that I had frankly never heard of until, you know, we had you guys on the air and, about a year or so ago.
Yeah.
And when we kind of got to know, you know, what you were doing and what the Fulfillment House is all about and its story. And, I mean, it's a not-for-profit organization and they do rely on funds and donations, as they say, to make an impact in the community. But, and there is an online giving button, by the way. Yes, you can click right through that and give a donation, which I would encourage you to do. More importantly, I just don't think you can put a value on what the Fulfillment House does for these, for the most part, young adults that are, working a job and have learned the very special aspect of the social function of working.
Yes.
I mean, how many of us, when you think about it, you go to work and about half of your day is spent just, you know, socializing. You're talking about what you did over the weekend. Mm-hmm. You're talking about what you want to do for Christmas and on and on and on. And if that is not a part of your working world, you're missing out.
Yeah.
And you all provide that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's so important that they are a part of that and get to experience that in life.
Right.
And just that enriching environment, you
right.
know, and that they're not just pushing a broom somewhere
right.
or, you know, just disregarded, that
right.
they are enriched and loved and embraced by the people around them. That is so important.
Yeah.
That they get to be a part of a community and a part of a family, and that we get to be a part of that. I love that I get to be a part of that, that I get to go to work and smile every single day, that I walked in the room and I get to smile. You know, yesterday as I was leaving, JT said to me, "Call me later, dude." And I thought,
right.
that's awesome. You know,
yes.
what a great kid. You know,
yes.
what a great way to leave the building. That's so fun. And just right. what a great day, you know.
Are you ever surprised by, you did mention that there were some, I guess, sort of quiet people who didn't really talk too much. The
mm-hmm.
associates have sort of come out of their shell.
Yeah.
Are you ever surprised by things that you see in the way of personal growth like that? Or is it a thing that you just expect by now?
I'm surprised every day by personal growth from people with special needs.
Isn't that awesome?
And I think that is the most amazing part of being around people like
right.
that, is that every single day something amazing happens, and it's something small and something amazing. But it doesn't have to be huge to be amazing. It can be something small, and it's significant because to them it's huge.
I
love that.
Indeed it is. And I think it's great to, you know, look, as you're raising kids, you know, expectations are everything. And I think if you have high expectations of kids at any level, they're going to deliver.
Yeah,
because they know it's expected of them.
Mm-hmm.
But to be able to put them in a position to sort of make that growth, those big steps
yeah.
on their own, is even more, here I'm going to say it, fulfilling.
Yes, absolutely.
At the Fulfillment House.
Absolutely.
And it is just wonderful. We are visiting today with Shawntel Reickard. She's the Executive Program Administrator to be. Very soon, by January the 2nd, you will be
yes.
at the Fulfillment House. And we're going to visit with Ashley Giglio, I believe, after the break. We're going to do that, guys? You want to do that?
Yeah.
All right. We'll bring Ashley back with us. Stay with us. You're listening to Kearney Live. It's Wednesday. We'll be right back.
Say thank you to these local businesses who support KPGZ.
Simplify your banking. Simplify your life. It's easy with Kearney Trust Company. The world has become fast-paced, and we understand that you are busy. That's why we offer a banking experience that's as simple and stress-free as can be. Kearney Trust goes beyond convenient locations and good customer care to offer banking services that make managing your finances quicker and easier than ever before. Online, bill pay, e-statements, and mobile banking are available to give you a positive banking experience so you can get back to your life and activities. Kearney Trust also provides capital to people and businesses so they can achieve their goals. Whether you know exactly what you want or just need someone to talk to about your dream, you can speak with them and work on that dream. You may just be getting off the ground or ready to move into your brick and mortar building. Kearney Trust will provide you and your business with the resources you need to succeed. Kearney Trust Company is your partner for success with two convenient locations in Kearney at 310 West 92 Highway and 701 Watson Drive in Price Chopper. The phone is 816-628-6666. Kearney Trust Company, banking you can trust. Member FDIC.
Is some of the absolute best bumper music I have heard.
And you know what?
What?
If I might, just a little plug here. So at 102.7 FM KPGZ, you'll notice that we play Christmas music, but we don't do it 24 hours a day. So just about that time when you find yourself going, that's enough of the Christmas songs.
Right.
Something else comes in.
Right.
And I noticed one of the other stations in town, I'm not going to name any names.
Please don't.
But they've already started saying,
right.
Are you tired of Christmas music? Because they play it 24 hours a day. And I think they realize people are like, I need a break for just a minute. And Brian does such a great job.
Exactly.
Of throwing in.
These. Well, it's not thrown in. No.
No, but he puts in a little variety just when you're like, I need a break.
He is a curator of music. And
makes you want to jump.
Oh, that is great.
Nicely done.
Wow. Listen to that.
Hey, let's jump to our guest. Mike, over to you.
We have Ashley Giglio, and she is an associate at the Fulfillment House. And Ashley, we are so glad to have you here.
Yeah, I'm so glad to have you too.
Well, welcome to the show. And by the way, we learned that your mother is Stacy Giglio, and she is one of our sponsors, the Cabana Tannery.
Yeah, that's right.
How much fun is that?
Yeah. Get your tan on.
I know. I love that. So how cool is that? Now, how long have you been an associate over there, Ashley?
A year.
So a full 12 months.
Yeah.
And what was it like on your first day? Were you nervous?
No. I love to work.
I can see that. And you came.
And I'm a hard worker.
Well, I don't have any doubt about that. In fact, you mentioned that at one point you had two jobs. Mm. You had, and tell us where else you worked.
I worked at Dairy Queen.
And the Fulfillment House.
Yeah, the Fulfillment
House. When did you have time to do anything else?
I just didn't.
You just stayed busy.
Yeah.
One of the things I noticed too when you first came in is you have a great sense of energy.
Yeah.
And you were well prepared to be on the radio and Facebook Live.
Yeah.
And you're doing a terrific job.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, well, I'm so glad you're here and happy to learn that your mother is a sponsor of 102.7 FM. And we hope more people do that for us because we can always use more sponsors. But I did want to just talk a little bit about your background. Did you graduate from Kearney High School?
Yes, I did graduate from Kearney High School.
And
I graduated 2012.
2012, very good. When you got out of high school, did you know you were going to work for the Fulfillment House?
Well, I actually helped my mom work at the tanning salon.
Oh, I see. Okay, of course.
Yeah.
And then how did you find out about Fulfillment House?
We knew Ken Thorne.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
And you just said, hey, I want a part of this. I want to get in on this.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, when you're fulfilling these books, and it looks like there's a lot of books and CDs and things of that nature. Are there ever any days where you say, wow, that was a difficult day?
No.
I knew you were going to say that. I set you up for that. You know that. Yeah. So yeah, you have fun working there. Mm-hmm. Tell me why that's so fun.
I just enjoy it. I just love working.
That's
what God made me, is a hard worker.
No doubt about that from the sounds of it. But I think the other thing too that I'm getting at is you have so many friends.
Yes.
And people there that you've gotten to know.
Mm-hmm.
And because you didn't know everybody when you first started working.
No.
And there are, I think I was corrected, there are 11 associates now. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So as you get to know, you know, some of the people that you work with, do you do things outside work?
Yeah, we go to the park and eat lunch.
Mm-hmm.
And we play basketball. Yeah.
And I understand there's a dice game that goes on.
Yeah.
What was the name of that game?
It's called 10,000.
Okay. No money involved in this.
No.
Right? Yeah.
No.
Yeah. No gambling. No wagering is going on at the fulfillment house. So if anybody was wondering, yeah, there's no wagering going on at 102.7 FM either. I don't think. Maybe fantasy football. Not even that. Brian's shaking his head. What else is going on over there?
We fold boxes. Like, I fold, like, a lot of boxes. Like, I can fold 100 boxes in, like, 5 minutes.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. You must be the champion box folder.
Must be.
Seriously, that is incredibly fast. So that is your specific job, then, in the fulfillment sort of chain of events.
And then sometimes I help warm up people's their food sometimes.
Okay. Well, very cool. Have you ever had an opportunity to meet any of the customers, any of these authors that write these books?
No.
Yeah, they haven't been in it yet.
No.
Yeah, because we were kind of hoping to see, let's see here, on partners, if you go on the website, there's Charles Payne. We talked about him earlier. We watch him on the news, on Fox Business News from time to time. And it'd be really neat if he came through someday, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would.
Be able to say hello to him. Yeah. Yeah, Jim?
By the way, Charles, if you want to come be on the show, you're more than welcome.
You think he's listening?
I'm sure he is.
Well,
I know he is. Because I was talking to Stuart this morning, Barney, and we were talking about his show, but I digress. And I noticed
you do always.
Again,
yes.
Yeah, I digress a lot. I noticed you started talking about food again. You brought us right back to food.
What's usually for lunch?
You were the one that brought up the Texas Roadhouse rolls.
I warm up people's like lunches.
Do they ever have rolls from like Texas Roadhouse?
No.
Or steaks?
Maybe
baked potatoes
again. So, well, take us through a typical day. So when you come in, what do you do on a normal day?
I clock in and then I sit down until we have staff meeting, and then we go and have staff meeting, and then. Once staff meeting, we go ahead and do our work. Like, we go ahead and start boxing the books and DVDs. And then...
What do you guys talk about at the staff meeting? Are you allowed to
We talk about what we did over the weekend or what we did last night.
Well, I think we need to change our staff meetings.
Too.
Because ours are not quite that fun.
We take ours a little too seriously.
Yeah, apparently. So, so do you guys... I mean, so you guys have fun at work.
Yes, we do.
See, I like the sound of that. Well, what are you looking at me for?
Well, Brian,
I was born to have fun.
I know, but Brian never lets us have fun. He's always like, work.
That is not true.
So could you explain to Brian for us how you have fun at work?
Yeah. After we do all our work, we have time to like play games.
That's fun. I like the sound of it. And basketball.
So
you have a basketball hoop inside?
Yeah. We have it outside in the back.
Okay. But it looks like you could during the bad weather. I mean, that building, I think, is big enough to put a little basketball court in there.
Yeah,
I'm
we
just
could.
Thinking, you know. I mean, I don't want to play basketball out in the cold.
Me either.
So folks know we're visiting with Ashley Giglio, and I had a little problem with the spelling and pronunciation of that, so I had to write it down phonetically, but I got it right, right?
Yeah.
Okay,
you do.
So just so Stacy knows, so your mom knows that I got this right. What did you, I'm curious, when you were working for your mom, what did you do over there at the tannery?
I would help clean beds. Mm-hmm. I put people in beds, like the customers in beds.
The tanning beds, right?
Yeah. And clean. And then after people are done tanning, I go in and clean them.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah. How easy is that?
Yeah, it's really easy.
So the real important question, what did you do at Dairy Queen?
I worked in the drive-thru, bring people their food out to them.
See, again with the food.
That's where this was headed.
Can you tell that I like food?
Yes, I can tell you really like food.
It's not a secret.
I like food, too.
Excellent. So maybe you can help us get some Texas Roadhouse.
Oh, sure can. Yeah. Guys, come out and bring these guys Texas Roadhouse. They are wonderful.
I like that, Ashley. I appreciate your effort. Now, you know Steve Thorne then, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, and is he a good guy or not?
Yes, he is really a good guy.
You're not just saying that because you're on the radio.
No. Right. I'm serious. He is really nice.
I think he is, too. I think he's done one heck of a job at putting together a business, I think, that does... provides fulfillment on a couple of different levels. Do you feel like you are fulfilled at the end of the day?
Yes.
I bet you are. Yeah, and it's a place you're really proud to say when people ask you where you work.
Yeah.
I bet you're excited to talk about it.
Yeah. I go from one work to the other work.
Oh, yeah. I know that feeling.
It's exhausting.
I'm tired thinking about it.
I know. So is there anybody you want to, over at the Fulfillment House, you want to give a little shout out to? Say hello.
Hi, Brent. Hi, everybody.
Brent. Brent's rather popular over there.
Why is Brent so popular?
He's a good guy.
That's true.
I'll give you that.
No doubt about that. I don't know. Thought maybe he had some special talents that you know. Does he play any musical instruments? Do you know?
No.
Yeah. All right. No harmonica, banjo?
No.
I could see him doing that, you know? Yeah. What a great guy.
He's actually my boyfriend.
Wait a minute. Now we're talking. Now you knew sooner or later this was going to come out on the air.
We've got some breaking news. Yes. Yeah. There you go.
Our audience. Yeah. They're amazed and shocked, if not alarmed.
How long has he been your boyfriend?
For a couple months.
A couple months. Excellent.
Lucky him, I would say.
Way to go, Brent.
Yeah.
Nicely done.
Oh, my goodness. Well, I think that's just another one of the many benefits at working at the Fulfillment House. You might find a boyfriend and or a girlfriend or something like that.
Yeah.
It looks to me. And you did, as it turns out. Yeah. Are there other associates over there that are boyfriend and girlfriend?
You know, no.
Nothing, none of that going on?
No.
Yeah. You sure about that?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay. I'm just looking at the picture here. You never know.
Yeah.
You know. Well, that's wonderful. How long have you known Brent?
For a year.
Well, that would make sense. I thought maybe perhaps that you had known him, before you started working at Fulfillment.
Oh, no.
I guess not. Yeah. Well, he's a man about town. That much I know. And quite popular around here, too. We love having him in here. In fact, Brent, come back anytime if you're listening. And I bet you are. Come on back to the radio station. We'll get you on the air. And we can talk a little bit about the same thing. Jim?
Does Brent like food?
Yeah, he loves food. We actually went out to Olive Garden once.
Did you really?
Yeah. It was his first time.
Did you make him pay?
No, my sister paid.
Oh, well, even better. I wish I could get that to happen.
Right. Yeah. Maybe your sister will pay for the Texas Roadhouse. Yeah. I don't know. That would be fun.
Well, by the way, sister, if you're listening, we're located at 455 Sandbar.
Right.
Suite 209. You know how that goes.
She knows how to get here. Yeah.
Bring rolls.
Absolutely. So what do you guys usually have for lunch? Does everybody bring their own lunch?
Yeah, everybody brings their own lunch.
Yeah, yep. Do you make your own lunch in the morning?
Yeah.
Typically? Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
What do you like to have?
Turkey sandwiches or leftovers the night before.
I like that. Yeah, turkey sandwich sounds good, and I'm a big fan of the leftovers as well. Yep. I work from home a big part of my day, and I do like to heat up some chili or spaghetti, stuff like that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, meatballs?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
My girl makes the best meatballs.
Now you're talking. Yeah. Well, and of course, it sort of makes sense that you are Italian then, right?
Yeah.
Well,
Part Italian.
I like the sound of that, and it makes me even hungrier than I already am. My goodness. Your friends who are the associates there, what are some of the things that you talk about when you said when you come in, you like at your meeting, your staff meeting, you talk about things that you did the night before or on the weekends.
Yeah.
What are some of the things that your friends are doing over on the weekends?
They're just hanging out or playing their video games.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. And watching movies, things like that. Or
the
movies that you like.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite movie?
Oh, my favorite movie? You mean Christmas movie?
Any kind of movie.
I like dog movies. I love dog movies.
Like what? 101 Dalmatians.
Yeah.
There you
go.
Yeah.
So are you guys, is the Fulfillment House all decorated up for Christmas?
Oh, yes, we are. We are.
Do you have all your Christmas shopping done?
Yeah.
Do you shop at the...
Shop local.
Fulfillment House?
No. We already had our Christmas party.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
So what did you guys do at the Christmas party?
We did Christmas exchange. It's called Secret Santa.
Oh, mm-hmm. I like that.
Yeah. Did you get what you wanted?
Yeah.
Excellent. We haven't done our Secret Santa.
No, we didn't.
No. I blame Brian for that.
I don't know about that.
Yeah. You know what I'd like? Rolls.
Lunch, right?
Yeah.
I also noticed, Jim, this is interesting too. In fact, this is right down the food sort of theme that we've started today. It says that you do bowling, yoga, and culinary classes. Now, you guys take cooking classes there at Fulfillment House, is that right?
Yeah.
Or maybe you haven't yet.
But no, it sounds I don't to me think like we have.
That's a thing that might have perhaps happened maybe before you got there.
But, yeah, maybe.
I would like for you to take a culinary class and okay. make something for Jim and me for lunch.
All right,
in
sure.
In the next 15
yeah,
minutes.
I can't.
If it's not too much to ask.
I'll have to go to my house and make it something.
Well, we'll see if your mom, Stacy, will have any part of that. Likely not. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure that Texas Roadhouse.
Yeah, I'm a good cook.
I have no doubt. What do you cook?
I make spaghetti. Mm-hmm. I make all kinds of stuff.
Anything in particular besides the spaghetti? Or is there anything non-Italian that you like?
No, I like macaroni and cheese.
Oh, yeah. Yep, that's one of my favorites.
And rolls.
Yes, I like rolls too.
I love rolls.
I like.
Can you tell?
Right. Yeah. I mean, same here.
There's a reason the camera stops right about here.
Yeah,
they've done that on purpose.
There are two meanings for the word rolls too, in case anybody wondered.
Thanks, Mike. I appreciate that.
Well, I'm right there with you, buddy.
Notice your camera's up a little high too.
It's going to shrink down a little bit. a little bit here. Yeah, I that's right. Do that. That's so, right. I just want folks to know we are visiting today with Ashley Giglio, and Ashley is let me get this right. You work at Fulfillment House.
Yeah.
You're an associate.
Yeah.
I forgot. Yes.
Yeah.
You're not an employee.
No.
I wonder, why do you think they call you an associate? I'm curious.
It's because we're adults and we work.
I like this. That's a great answer. It really is. Yeah. I mean, I know I hear there are a lot of companies who refer to their employees as associates.
Yeah.
And I think associate, when you say that, it makes it sound like, and it's true, mm-hmm. You are an essential part of what goes on in the business.
Yeah.
And I think, because without you, it wouldn't happen. Things wouldn't be fulfilled.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, I am so happy that we got to meet you.
Yeah, I'm so happy I got to meet you guys, too.
Well, come back anytime.
Okay,
will you do that?
Yes, I will.
And Jim has something. Yep.
No, I was just going to say, have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Tell everybody over there, are you going back today? Or
no, I'm off.
I like the way that sounds. I do that too. I'm out of here.
But, you guys have a Merry Christmas and New Year's too.
Yeah, tell everybody when you go back. Do you go back tomorrow?
Yeah, I go back tomorrow.
Tell everybody Merry Christmas over there. And Brent.
I will.
Yep. Tell Brent Merry Christmas.
I will.
Tell him he better be nice to you.
I will.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you, Ashley.
That's you too.
Ashley Giglio, and we've been visiting with the folks from the Fulfillment House. And if you don't know their story, get on the fulfillmenthouse.org. Read about where this company came from. Read about what they've been doing over the course of the last, how many years? 12 years? I hear the bumper music, but I can't hear what you're saying, so. But for quite some time.
Studio audience is way out there.
Yes, they are. Thank you all for joining us today. It's been a very special day. I love it. Love, love it. When the folks from Fulfillment House come in the studio, it's always fun. If you folks want to stop by there, I'm sure they'd love to have you around lunchtime. And give them a call first, though. Might not be a bad idea. And also a big thank you to Shawntel Reickard. Thank you, the soon-to-be Executive Program Administrator at Fulfillment House. Thanks for all you do. We appreciate you and all of you listeners and our sponsors and everybody. Merry Christmas from 102.7 FM. Thanks so much for being with us this year on Kearney Live on Wednesdays at noon. We love you, and keep coming back. We'll be here. See you next time.